听专家解读美国升学方案，看美国学习生活点滴，圆美国名校梦想。本节目由美国文美教育集团冠名播出。
大家好，欢迎来到文美集团美国升学直通车。文美集团美国升学直通车是华人网与文美教育集团联合制作播出的北美首档大型的网络直播教育节目。在我们的节目当中，你将会了解到最新最权威的教育资讯，还有升学的建议。在我们的整个节目过程当中，无论您是学生还是家长，有任何的美国升学教育问题，都可以来给我们留言。那么首先呢，还是要来给大家介绍一下文美集团。文美集团是享誉美国的华人教育集团，藤校申请大满贯。他们15年只做一件事，那就是为在美华人子女提供大学申请及规划服务。全美有12家办公室，7天营业，万博士领衔的硕博顾问团队，尽心为华人子女提供最专业、最诚信的教育服务。欢迎大家扫码或者是直接搜索关注文美集团的微信公众号美国升学网，及时了解最新最全的美国升学资讯。如果想跟文美的客服互动，请在节目播出期间扫描屏幕左下角的文美客服二维码，或者是直接搜索微信号文美集团的全拼音。小红书也请搜索并关注文美集团。文美的咨询热线是18887890942。今天在我线上的是文美教育集团的总监万博士。万博士好，好久不见。
主持人好，华人网的观众朋友们大家好。
是的，这个万博士中间这个非常的忙碌，所以呢没有给我们进行这个节目的更新，但是从今天开始这个万博士会把他这一季的这样的一个录取的情况，还有他们这个文美为大家做到的一些事情来跟大家这个分享。所以我们今天呢会跟这个万博士首先请他来分享这个被 UCLA、UCB 还有杜克以及是约翰斯霍普金斯大学同时录取的这样的一位学霸同学的案例。哎，万博士这个首先还是来跟我们稍微分享一下现在我们知道这个2023应该是2024年的这样的一个录取季这个已经是陆续的这样的一个出来了，你们今年文美的成绩如何呢？
好的，今天呢我觉得是到了已经四月份了所以我觉得是很好的一个时间段来给我们的家长呢通报一下2024年大学申请的一个形式。因为到了4月1号之后几乎所有的大学的录取结果都已经公布了，那当然有三个选择，要么是录取了，要不然是拒绝了，还有一个叫 wait list。
对
有这三个选项那么文美集团呢今年的录取的一些结果呢，我们也在我们的一些社交媒体账号进行了公布。整体上来说呢还是不错，但是呢我们也明显感觉到之所以是这样，是因为学生的质量在上升，但是其实我们的整个录取的结果其实和去年前年差不多，是基本上持平的。也就是说录取结果我们的收获没有特别明显的变化，说我们又多了多少顶级名校好像没有那但是呢但是我个人的感觉就是我由于越来越卷，所以呢
真的
华人的质量其实是在逐步的上升，我们的学生的质量是在逐步的上升的回归到这个2024年的录取的一个整体的一个形式的话呢首先呢录取率呢大家知道我在做节目的时候我不太愿意看这个什么所谓的录取率因为我关注我们每个孩子自己能做到多么的优秀，做最好的自己吧。我一直强调的一点，哈佛、耶鲁、斯坦福是吧，它的录取率又提高了 0.1 个百分点，今年多招了20个人还是少招了50个人，其实对于我们个体上来说没有实际的影响，所以我不是那种数据哥、 PPT 哥是吧，所以这个我就不介绍这些数据了。但是呢我们明显感觉到这个录取的这些学生里边的话呢，一个明显的一个趋势就是说对这个领导力的这个特别重视的这个程度是非常注重，以及这个社会责任感这些东西那当然了，那这个整体上来说的话呢 UC 加州大学的这个录取的话呢出现了比较明确的一个变化那这个明确的一个变化呢就是说 UCLA、 Berkeley 这两个学校根据加州政府的规定90%以上的要招本州的学生也就是说他招外州学生比例越来越低因为他是公校受政府 款，那么反而是像这个Irvine、San Diego、Davis 这些学校的话呢，在这个扩大了这个对外州学生的一个招生的比例啊，那当然了，一些更加具体的一些数据的话呢，各个大学随着它申请季的结束呢，陆陆续续它会公布哈，那么我们之后有机会也会跟大家分享啊，所以这个就是简单的一个目前的一个申请的一个形式吧，好吧？那么今天我跟大家分享的这个案例呢是很具有代表性的啊。那么它有一种说法叫全聚德，那它就是大满贯了，是吧？那么
没错，
这个因为这个全美最顶级的几个大学基本上都录取了，而且之所以把它拿出来呢，就是跟刚才我说的这今年的整个申请形式有一定的关系啊。那么大家可以看看它这个录取的这个榜单哈，那它这个它这个榜单的话呢，大家明显可以看一下，UCLA 伯克利 UC 系列基本上全录取了，这个是非常罕见的啊。我刚才讲了，这个学生的话呢，他又是在外州啊，为什么呢？这种情况在加州的学生我是这么多年没遇到过，说咱们加州本州的居民同时被这么多学校同时录取，那这个其实是比较罕见的一种情况哈。那么所以我今天把它拿过来和大家分享一下啊。那首先先看一下它的整个的一个学生的一个情况，它是在佛罗里达州。我先说一下这个州的政策啊，这个州是我服务，因为我服务全美各地的学生嘛，对比起来加州、纽约州、佛罗里达州，我经常一遇到佛罗里达的学生，我就会说，我说哎呀，我都想搬到佛罗里达去，为了我的孩子。为什么呢？因为佛罗里达它有两个特别好的政策，我觉得在全美申请大学的时候非常具有竞争力。一个就是九年级选个三四门 AP 课是不成问题的，无论是公校，这在加州、纽约州、德州都是不可想象的。那么第二点呢，就是从十一年级开始，他们是有这种 dual enrollment 的政策，就是你有可以在学校高中上课，也可以直接转到高中，他每一个高中都有对应的一个学院，那他可以是社区学院或者 state university， 那么去那儿直接上学，那么也就是说他直接修大学课，那就类似于这种 AP 课的质量了啊，那就非常高，明白吧？所以呢，我觉得就是说从这两点上来说呢，这个学生能被这么多名校录取呢，其实也就不奇怪了啊。就是说在各个大学招生的时候，他从来要考虑到这个种族的因素啊，还有就是要考虑到你的这个区域的这个因素啊，区域的这个因素是非常非常重要的。同样的成绩啊，他又你在不同的地区有不同的竞争力，你在同一个州在不同的学区也具有不同的竞争力啊。那么你看它的 AP 科目十门，竞赛无，科研无， SAT 无。
对，我看到这三个无我真的很惊讶哎，万博士。
是吧？对，所以它的 GPA 4.0 是十门 AP 课的 4.0， 所以你要知道，如果咱们加州的孩子啊，这个成绩甭说 UCLA Berkeley 了，那么 Irvine San Diego
可能都没有
是不是？
对，
所以呢就是说这个我就讲了，这叫区域的多元化。因为 UCLA Berkeley 之所以录取它，刚才讲了哈，那就是因为它跟有外州的有这个竞争如此的激烈，但是呢它要交外州的这个学费，要外州的学费啊，所以能录取它。我觉得当然它在我看上边有一些无，当然在他的课外活动方面、领导力方面啊，这个因为他不是数据啊，我没有展现出来，他其实是非常非常非常非常强的啊。所以呢，这个案例呢，其实不是特别具有典型性，但是我今天通过他的案例呢，我想分享给大家，就是说那些个刚刚因为这个最近我就有一个家长要从移民过，刚刚要移民。这个过来啊，马上要面谈啊什么之类的啊，那我跟他咨询的时候我就建议千万不要来加州啊，千万不要来加州，如果你想来加州上学的话是吧，就是说加州现在已经卷的到了一定的程度啊，
太可怕了加州。
那么尤其是这个亚裔 这个就是跟私校、公校不一样。之前咱们有期节目做过啊，关于这个私校和公校，怎么来选择，他们有什么招生特点？公校一个特点就是它不是光看学习成绩的。你看它这也不是光看学习成绩，你看它这样的成绩有竞争力吗？没有竞争力，
对，
是不是？它要看种族、你的地区，是吧？那 UC 加大真州本州的居民又出了一个新的政策，到2030年。那么它的这个招生的这个比例里边要进一步提高这个西语裔 Hispanics 这个黑人的这个招生比例啊，那意味着要进一步的下降这个亚裔的招生比例啊，所以这个竞争是更加的激烈。还有一个原因就是更加激烈的原因，就是因为 UCLA Berkeley 这两年的排名大踏步的上升，整个 UC 都上升了十几名。那么导致了一个情况是什么？导致了一个情况就是因为它越来越好，排名越来越高，它的入学率就高了。入学率高了之后，它的招生人数就会变少。为什么呢？因为每个大学它都在算一个入学率的问题。这个入学率就是说，那这个我录了100个人，有多少个人来报到？原来的话呢，UCLA Berkeley 大概30多个人，现在涨到将近40个人了。那当然了，他就没必要招这么多人了嘛。原来的话，三分之一的比例是吧？我的目标是招5000人，那我要收15000人。那现在我录取率是，入学率是50%了，那我招10000人就可以了。那你说他招生人物录取信的人数就少。
嗯，
当然了，今年 UC 还有一个特点，就是大量的这个wait list。这个 wait list 是比往年都要多了1/3，我觉得我的感觉啊。哦这么多，所以大家呢还是对 waitlist 还是可以有所期待的啊。大家知道，在2020年疫情那一年，加州大学伯克利 UC 伯克利的话，它的 waitlist 转正率达到了创纪录的30%。所以呢，这个的话呢，我觉得这个waitlist 的话，大家一定要关注，千万别错过了。给你发邮件了，然后你不查邮件，最后错过了啊，这个是非常可惜的。好，那么这个。这个就是你看它的课外活动有20个项目啊，这个俱乐部啊，什么领导力啊，文美的义工啊，包括我们还帮他策划了一个非盈利的组织啊，所以我觉得这些也是在他成绩一般的情况下怎么帮他脱颖而出，除了他有地理位置优势以外，另外的一个优势。那么他最终选择去杜克大学啊，所以我觉得趁着这个机会也跟大家分享一下啊，每日一笑是吧？那么这个杜克大学啊。杜克大学的话呢，也是进入了全美前10名，现在排名是第8名的一个学校啊，那也是出了总统是吧 ，Tim Cook， 是吧，这些个盖茨是吧，所以这个杜克大学呢是非常棒的一个大学，那我也是给大家推荐，除了它本身排名高，出了这么多名人之外，教学质量很高之外。我的一些进到这个学校的学生都给我反馈的就是这个学校对我们亚裔还是非常友好的，包括杜克大学在吸引我们华裔的教授科研人员方面的比例也是相当可以的啊。所以你在进到这个大学的时候呢，会我觉得会是比较舒服的一个学校啊，会是比较舒服的一个学校。那么当然了，这里边有一些他的一些个每年的录取的一些个录取率6%是吧，人数是6000多人是吧，SAT 1520到1570，但是这个孩子没有 SAT 啊，无 SAT 的啊，所以这里边当然之后咱们还会再讲啊，之前也分析过，那么这个孩子是选择了 undecided 的 major 啊，先进去再进一个调整啊，所以这个是和我们的很多亚裔说一定要读计算机，一定要这个有非常大的一个区别的啊，大家再看看它的这个招生比例，你看杜克大学的 Asian 的比例其实并不高，21%，哈佛的招生 Asian 的比例可能要在30%了将近啊，那么 UCLA Berkeley 是更高达34%是吧，所以呢你就知道杜克大学这个还是可以我们申请的，因为它的比例还没有那么高啊，好吧。那么今天节目时间关系啊，我就跟大家分享这么多啊，在接下来的节目里我还会把更多的一些今年的案例呢分享给大家，希望大家持续关注我们的节目。
哎，是的， 谢谢这个万博士的分享。我觉得其实对于很多的家长和同学们来说哈，这个经常听万博士讲一些这些相关的一些这个信息哈，可能会比较的这个抽象一点，但是这样的一份案例放到你面前，这个作为家长和学生可能就要好好思考自己应该怎么样来去进行哈。当然我们在这里还是建议大家要找这个文美，找万博士啊，因为他们非常有经验。然后像刚才万博士您讲到的一些信息，其实我们家长和同学们都是不知道的。所以呢，大家如果有任何的问题呢，都是可以直接来咨询我们的文美集团的。文美集团是享誉美国的华人教育集团，藤校申请大满贯。他们15年只做一件事，那就是为在美华人子女提供大学申请及规划服务。全美有12家办公室，7天营业。万博士领衔的硕博顾问团队尽心为华人子女提供最专业最诚信的教育服务。欢迎大家扫码或者是直接搜索关注文美集团的微信公众号美国升学网，及时了解最新最全的美国升学资讯。如果想跟文美的客服互动，请在节目播出期间扫描屏幕左下角的文美客服二维码，或者是直接搜索微信号文美集团的全拼音。小红书也请搜索并关注文美集团。文美的咨询热线是18887890942。万博士，这个我们今天好像有另外的一位你们的文美的美籍顾问要来跟大家分享一下这个有关升学规划的这样的一个情况。我知道他好像是这个康奈尔大学的一位面试官 Mr. Pierre， 能不能先给大家稍微介绍一下？
好的，那么学生现在越来越卷，大学越来越卷，我们的服务也要跟着卷上去啊。所以这个是所以这是我们的一个初衷吧，是吧？因为为了更好的提高我们学生的竞争力，为我们孩子做更好的规划，所以我们文美集团在2024年推出了这个叫中美双顾问模式啊。那么中美双顾问模式的意思呢，就是说一个中方顾问，一个美方顾问啊。那么这个美方顾问的质量也是非常高的啊。那么包括这个 Mr. Pierre 那么他就是康奈尔大学的校友，也是康奈尔大学的面试官啊。那么我们希望呢，有他的这种加入，能够给我们的这些孩子做规划，每个月的定期的会议，有中方的会议，也有美方的会议，从不同的视角，从招生官的视角，从我们华人的视角，给孩子提供最全面的帮助。那么当然随着我们服务的这些孩子们英语越来越好，除了移民学生之外，我们美国出生长大的这些华二代的比例也逐步上升哈。那么我的这个英语呢，说实在的啊，还是 Chinese English， 是吧？所以呢所以我还是让我们的这个美方顾问的这个加入能够给我们带来更好的效果，给我们的孩子提供更强的竞争力吧。所以今天呢让这个皮埃尔先生呢跟我们的家长第一次见面啊，先跟大家分享一下如何选择自己梦想的大学，应该从哪些方面去考量，再制定一个比较好的一个申请策略。
好的，是的，这个，所以大家这个如果是有兴趣的话，或者是想更多的了解，一定要关注我们的节目哈。下面我们有请这个皮埃尔先生来为大家讲解如何帮助孩子找到自己梦想的大学。
Hi, this is Pierre, admissions consultant for WinMay. Today's topic is how to find your dream school. In other words, making the decision about where you're likely to go to college for the next 4 years. So there are 8 elements we're going to consider. They are self-assessment, research, campus visits, talking with current students or alumni, considering financial aid and scholarships, reviewing admission requirements, evaluating fit, and seeking guidance. So I've actually prepared examples of each thing. So we'll go over that. So the first element is self-assessment. You want to be reflecting on your interests, your strengths, your weaknesses, your goals, and basically look inward. And, you know, the first big decision would be choosing your major, because that can help filter out a lot of choices for you. And in the end, there are also going to be websites that can help you find your ideal college, your dream college. So this is an example of such a website. So you would sign up, answer a few questions, and then they would give you some suggestions based on your preferences. And you want to consider many different factors when you're looking at different schools beyond just academics. You want to be looking at the environment, the location, the campus size, extracurriculars, and other things that might be important, for example, like the cost of living. The next element is research. So this is the time to look up college websites, to look up rankings, possibly brochures, and you want to look into more specific things. For example, academic programs, campus facilities, things that will be available to you, like student life, for example, once you're actually at the college. And for that, I have this ranking list, which is the go-to when you want to consider specific things. So in this case, we are looking at the top colleges, and these are just some examples. So we have Princeton, MIT, Harvard, Stanford, Yale, and you can see the different information here. For example, how many people were enrolled for undergraduate, the cost of attending, and different elements like that. And then you can also enter more specific things over here if you want to search a specific school, or you want to filter things by tuition and fees, enrollment, acceptance rate, area of study, majors, and you can go on to many different fields. Just to see like some good programs in the specific thing that you're interested in, whether it's engineering or mathematics or a different major. Next factor will be campus visits. So they can be virtual or in person. And the idea is that this is going to be your preview of the layout of the campus, the facilities. Possibly you can even attend the lecture. So this would be for Cornell University, which is my alma mater. You have the option of scheduling an in-person tour or taking a virtual tour. So obviously this is Cornell during the winter. And typically in a tour, what you'll find is chances to interact with students, possibly faculty, and just get the overall impression of the school. Like the buildings, the atmosphere, the weather, of course. So it's definitely worth doing that, and most people will plan like college visits like in a trip, so they'll visit like 3 to 4 campuses that are in the same area, for example. So this is obviously going to be a really good idea because you get to see where you'll possibly be living for the next 4 years once you're in college. Okay. So the next factor would be keeping in touch with current students and alumni. So Stanford actually offers something called the Student Forum, which is basically like a 1 hour session that's only open to students that are interested in applying. And you can have live question and answer sessions with current Stanford undergraduates, and you can ask about many different topics such as housing, dining, dorm life, student life and academics. And the best part is that it's essentially only between the Stanford undergraduates and the prospective students, so you don't have to feel the pressure to ask certain questions. You can kind of relax a little bit more and ask questions that, you know, you think will be important to know before you make a decision of going to Stanford. Okay, the next option would be considering financial aid and scholarships. So This would be the source for Harvard. And you can find many different elements of information here. Like if you're a foreign student, information about FAFSA, if you missed a financial aid deadline. And they explain the process, they have graphs and charts. And you can see many different aspects of financial aid. And obviously the cost of attending is going to be really important because that might limit where you can go. But some schools are need blind, so they won't use that as a factor to decide whether you can go there or not. And I would say that typically the better schools are going to have really good plans in place, financial aid to help you make sure that you can go there. And the rest of this page is going to be more information about asking questions about financial aid. So that's really important. You can have scholarships, grants, things like work study, you know, that can help you pay for your schooling. There's also like plans in place to like prepaid college programs. That would be more for like parents that have been paying like a monthly installment and before their kid was even born in some cases, so that by the time they are ready for college, they can essentially cover the cost of college already. Okay, so that's really important to make sure that you're going to be able to afford where you're going to go. And there's things like financial aid that can help you do that. Okay, so the next topic is really important, and it's going to be admissions requirements. So this is for MIT, which they do their own thing in terms of admissions. They have their own admissions process. It's not Common App, and it's not like the UC app, for example. And here, this is straight from their website. They're giving you some things that you need in order to make it to MIT. Some things that you're going to be required to do. So for academics, they recommend 2 semesters of calculus, for example, 2 semesters of calculus-based physics, 1 semester of chemistry, 1 semester of biology. And you can see more specific things here. And these are the typical classes that an MIT student would have taken in high school. And they go on to tell you about completing things like dual enrollment, more advanced courses. You can also do like open courseware, taking AP classes. So MIT open courseware. Dual enrollment is going to be really important because it's showing that you're going above and beyond what's offered in your high school curriculum. In other words, you're taking college courses with college students, and you'll be able to take, for example, more advanced math than your school can offer, which is something I did myself. And that can look really good for colleges. While not necessarily being a requirement, notice that they word it as academic achievement. And then they talk about your extracurriculars, which is obviously going to be really important because they want to make sure that you're being productive. And they also want to know what you're doing with your time outside of classes, for example. And so you'll see some descriptions of that there, about the types of extracurriculars they should be choosing. And they have some links to other articles. And you want to make sure that you have the GPA requirements, you have the SAT scores, you have good extracurriculars, different things like that. And so the last thing, so this would be like an example of what I was talking about. So they give you like the SAT range, and they give you some descriptions about MIT. And here's even a video that you can watch about advice from someone that made it to MIT, looking back, things that they would have told themselves. Okay. The next thing is evaluating fit. So this is something that's overlooked a lot. It's the idea of how well a college fits you. In other words, you're going to have your preferences, things that you want to do, things that are important to you. You need to take those into account even after you come up with your college list. So your college list should be based on 10 colleges approximately, 8 to 10. And it should be separated into different tiers. So the first tier is going to be your dream schools, which are going to be your top choices. So it's going to be between 1 to 2 schools. Then the next tier are going to be your target schools. So that's going to be composed of 3 to 4 colleges. Those are schools that are really good, but it's a little bit more realistic to be accepted into those schools. And then you have the third tier, which is going to be your safety schools. So those are schools that you'd also be happy to go to, but they're essentially like your backup plan. And this also means that you have a better chance of getting into those schools compared to the other tiers. So that would be like a good application strategy. That's what a good college list can look like. But even after you come up with your list, you need to make sure that the college fits you. So you need to take your preferences into account, but also some general things such as academics, which is what you're primarily there to do, to earn your degree, and your education. Campus culture, you're going to be living there, right, for essentially the next 4 years. So you need to make sure that you're okay with the layout of the campus, maybe the traffic, student interaction, the facilities, different things like that. For example, at Cornell, we're required to take a swim test before we graduate because there are a lot of bodies of water around the campus, so they need to ensure that you can swim. So actually, you need to pass the swim test in order to graduate. That's how important that is. Things like financial aid, which we discussed. And something that's really important would be career development. In other words, job placement. So even after you're earning your degree, how well does the school do in helping people find jobs after they graduate? So that's something that should be really important as well. And of course, any other of several multitude of factors that you might consider important. Okay, so the last thing that we wanted to talk about was seeking guidance. And that just brings us back to Winmei. So we've been helping students with admissions consulting. We have a lot of experience with different colleges, getting students into the top colleges, and we're here to help. So when it comes to seeking guidance, we are talking about asking people about their experiences, having someone look over your case and give you specific suggestions, come up with an action plan, provide you with resources. We also help with test prep, for example, SAT, which is also something that I do. So we know how to approach those things, and that's what we're here to do. We're here to help.
好的，非常感谢万博士给我们带来这个 Mr. Pierre 先生的这样的一个介绍哈，因为我觉得可能对于很多的这个家长来说哈，这样的一位真正的面试官来给大家讲的话，大家可能会这个感触更深，是这样吗，万博士？
希望是这样吧，这也是我们想达到的效果。尤其是我们这个方案实施以来呢，我们发现家长可能不一定喜欢，因为家长大部分听不懂或者能。
学生比较喜欢。
所以交流起来，家长更愿意和我们的华人顾问来沟通，但是孩子们特别喜欢，因为孩子尤其是这些美国出生长大的孩子，他们有这种西方的背景和这种价值观的话，跟他沟通起来 会非常的顺畅。所以我们目前我们这个采用了这个中美双顾问模式之后呢，既满足了家长的需求，又满足了孩子的需求，所以我觉得这也是我们文美现在的又一大核心竞争力了。
是的，
希望大家。
是的，这个万博士说，这个我们这个学生在卷哈，这个万博士也在卷，然后呢，我们希望这个越卷哈，让大家这个越好。所以呢，这个当然如果有任何的问题的话，大家还是可以直接来咨询我们的文美集团。文美集团是享誉美国的华人教育集团，藤校申请大满贯，他们15年只做一件事，那就是为在美华人子女提供大学申请及规划服务。全美有12家办公室，7天营业，万博士领衔的硕博顾问团队尽心为华人子女提供最专业最诚信的教育服务。欢迎大家扫码或者是直接搜索关注文美集团的微信公众号美国升学网，及时了解最新最全的美国升学资讯。如果想跟文美的客服互动，请在节目播出期间扫描屏幕左下角的文美客服二维码，或者是直接搜索微信号文美集团的全拼音。小红书也请搜索并关注文美集团。文美的咨询热线是18887890942。今天谢谢万博士来到我们的节目给大家带来的讲解，辛苦您。
谢谢主持人，谢谢大家。
是的，感谢大家收看我们今天的节目，我们下期见。